Welcome back to Let's Play the Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos. I am the RPG Chick, and we're continuing to explore this Holey Caves Prophet of Profitability complex. Check out the old radio. And these are actually cards. But I thought it was Monopoly, or Life Money at first. Well, there's a few little things, but it's not worth getting caught and attacked by people for. Look at the skull! Preparatory punch, and a skull. Well, we got bits.
Okay.
Bits talk. Probably punch walks. Oh, we can sleep here if you wanted to. Another skull, although that might just be a prop for a candle. Oh, well, here's worth it. Here's worth it. Come on inside, guys. Here's some alone time with all these goodies. With the mag pick. They're crouching too, just looking over. Yeah, I'm not gonna reach this. It's nothing that great. There aren't even that many bits in there. Am I overweight? Oh, I am. Just barely overweight here. Oh, this is better armor. So we can break this down, yeah. These hunting rifles. What's most likely this stuff? These are like a pound each. You guys can have that. Chow down, disciples. Pocket watch. Blood or just gunk from whatever this machine is? Definitely not much of interest going on in these rooms. God, that's not gonna help me. Robot things? For some reason, I'm thinking robot things. wasn't really the gun I wanted.
Well, your skills are unrivaled.
She's puking. Too busy puking to attack us. Can you imagine? Not sure if I should be grossed out or offended. Oh, what we got here? Some kind of terrarium for something? She's growing the little mind-controlling slug things, isn't she? Oh, there's the geological survey. It's all coming together here. We've got a door here that we can pick. A mag pick to pick. Geological survey notes. The world is beautiful beyond compare. I can see colors I never imagined existed. The sky has a voice and it's singing to me. I see the truth now. I see everything so clearly, so perfectly. The storms of Eridanos are notes in a great cosmic orchestra. The stars are the choir of the universe. And every word they sing is joy. I can't seem to stop smiling. I don't want to stop smiling. Ever. Righto. You might be smiling even in death. Oh, search the Holey caves for 3 geological surveys, then return them to Virgil Henderson. These don't look anything like caves. That's why it wasn't really what I was expecting. So I found 2? I don't remember this one. Corporate authorized the name Eridanium gagaceous to describe the life form. Once we determine whether the creature is a viable flavoring agent, confection ingredient, or drinkable after fermentation, Rizzo's company branding department will provide a more consumer-friendly name. The life form is a parasite. Dissection reveals an incomplete system of rudimentary internal organs. A half creature, an unfinished accident, or orthogenesis. Not familiar with that word. But how can this be? Eridanos is hostile to all life forms. Parasitism implies a rich biological diversity. I theorize that Eridanium gagaceous is not truly endemic to the Eridanos planet. I guess Eridanos is a planet, right? It was a moon. But was created in the organic waste of the same terraforming system that operates the atmospheric complex. Continuing my investigation. More reports to follow. Happy to be a part of the Rizzo's family. Dr. Amir Zao, team biologist, Rizzo's Department of Geological Survey and Territorial Expansion. And this survey note is a lot different. So we found 2? I don't know if that counts as 1. I don't even know when I found that. I do remember reading it, though, so I figured it would be... Whoops. I did not press that. Must have a loose button or something. Alright. We got these little guys in here. Yeah, there's no getting past that, right?
Easy.
Don't tell me easy. I'll bust it open if I want to. With zeal, because we're in the caves of zeal. Yeah, looks pretty impassable. Oops. Oh, where's that go? Alright, what about this then? Darkness. Well, I think there's a computer back there I didn't even look at. Terminal. What have you. It's pretty dark in here. Sure, it's even darker for the YouTubes. Rizzo's R&D Communications Terminal. Yeah. Happy customers or repeat customers, etc. Open last entry. Oh, this is to A. Zhao, the geological survey note we just read. From Human Resources Division, Rizzo's Corporate. Subject, Notice of Expiration. Dr. Amir Zhao, this is to inform you that Rizzo's has been notified of your expiration date due to one or more of the following causes. 1. Violent physical trauma. 2. Accidental encounter with local fauna. 3. Severe physiological reaction to company and company adjacent products. 4. Destruction of company property. After careful review, Rizzo's Office of Human Resources has approved the dissolution of your indenturement contract. In accordance with Rizzo's company law, your closest living relatives will be rewarded the following. 1 regulation-sized crate of Rizzo's Spectrum Brown to be delivered within 6 to 8 weeks of product launch. Please note that, as a gesture of gratitude for your service, your shipping and delivery fees have been waived. Look at that. Your work on behalf of the Rizzo's Geological Survey team has proved invaluable in the development and upcoming launch of Rizzo Spectrum Brown. Thank you for being part of the Rizzo's family. This is an automated message. Responses to this message have been disabled. Query: Supervisor Clearance. Accessing information on Supervisor Clearance. Supervisor Clearance has been granted to Q. Ludovico and A. Zhao. Please note, in accordance with Rizzo's company policy, supervisor clearance is a privilege, not a right. Clearance may be revoked in the event of gross misuse, behavior contrary to Rizzo's company values, or dissonant adjacent behavior. I like that word. Noun-adjacent. Access usage records for supervisor clearance. Error. Data corruption detected. Usage records inaccessible. Now generating error report. Error. Error report corrupted. Failsafe protocol activated. Now dumping memory contents. Dump successful. Access? Yes. Now printing memory contents. And it's in assembly code or something. Isolate passcode. Sorting by linguistic significance. Isolating possible matches. Match detected. Isolating passcode. Isolation successful. Passcode is CAVI14620. It's like a zip code. Do I have to know this? I mean, it's probably going to fill it in automatically, but what if I have to know it, right? What if I have to enter it in manually? So I just want to write it down. Write it down, man. Write it down. CAVI 14620. Clicks, sorry. Memorize the passcode. Okay, I guess the computer would do it for us. And what if I had said no? I didn't want to say... I was curious what would happen if I said no, but I was afraid that we would never have an opportunity to say yes after that. Right, so this one. Parasite Research Facilities. Experiment Logs Database. View Lab Notes. Searching Database. 556 entries found. Warning. 556 out of 556 files corrupted. Run recovery routine? Yes. Attempting to recover. Failed to recover 554 files. Files successfully recovered. Well, that makes it easier for us to read through it. two files available. What's this with log 3? You lie. There's 3 available. Okay, access log 1. Eridanium gigaceous research notes number 1. I've completed my final record of total immersion suspension and exposure tests. As expected, Eridanium gigaceous dissolves in acid, burns in fire, and can be disintegrated or otherwise destroyed with N-rays or concentrated blasts of plasma. The creature is vulnerable when alone. However, bonding with a host evokes intensely protective behavior from that host. Safeguarding the parasite becomes the host's primary objective, even to the point of aggression and violence. You know, they were like extremely happy at the same time. The creature also seems well suited to long-term hibernation and immersion in a liquid suspension. Water and low-grade alcohols preserve the creature. Its metabolic systems, such as they are, slow to a halt. Once exposed to a host, the creature emerges from its dormant state and immediately attempts to attach itself to the host's nervous system. Water and low-grade alcohols preserve the creature. Long-term dormancy in an alcohol solution may prove useful to corporate. I'll prepare my report tomorrow. The Spectrum Brown. The Spectrum Brown, or maybe all the Spectrums vodka? All you need to do is drink that, and the things are in it. Right. Amazing. Alright. Access log 2. Eridanium gigaceous research notes 2. The parasite seems completely incompatible with the common sprat. That's why I see those things all around. This is baffling and disappointing. I have a few theories. 1. Sprat nucleotides are highly adaptive. Eridanium gigaceous is a half-complete creature. Adaptive mutations in sprat physiology render it a poor host to the parasite. 2. Eridanium gigaceous has a particular and discerning sense of taste and finds sprats, accordingly, distasteful. Don't blame it. Option 2 is ridiculous to me, but not, strictly speaking, impossible. Could both be true? I'm delirious. We'll delete in the morning. Oh, we found it. And then, access log 3. Research notes number 3. Continuing my search for more suitable hosts among common fauna. Very promising results from terror rays. Their biological system is well suited to hosting the parasite. My theory? The parasite enjoys exposure to the atmosphere of Eridanos and may be manipulating the terror rays into more frequent and aggressive flight. In every case, the parasite successfully manipulated production of hormones in the host's brain. I don't know how yet. The implications of a parasite manipulating its host troubles me. Its nervous system is exotic and difficult to understand. I can't quite shake the idea that the parasite does not require contact with its host in order to influence its behavior. A suitably large and complex specimen may be able to manipulate the mood of a sentient creature by proximity alone. Maybe. Possibly. These ideas are unscientific and founded on my own anxieties. My nightmares have been muddying my thoughts. Should seek treatment soon. Well, I want to run into this Dr. Zhao. Hope he's still alive. Because he knows as much about these things as anybody, I would guess. Alright, so where's this go?
Nice and easy.
Whoa! Where's this go? Well, it goes down here. Into actual caves. Guessing that, yeah, these geological surveys. These are the other two. Not the one from Dr. Zhao. I found it somewhere else. We go up. red blips. But I hear stuff. Big creatures. There's a big boy. Where's a big boy? Where's a big boy? There is a big boy. Hunting rifle hyper. Whoa. Whoa! Where the hell did that come from? I think Ellie just saved my life. That thing must have dropped down from the ceiling. Yeah, there's more nasty stuff in here. Parasite jelly, yummy! BB&J. Canid host. Well, look at these bones. Well, those look like human bones. Awful lot of noise coming in that direction. Dead already.
Well done. We are victorious.
It stopped attacking. I thought it was dead. We're victorious, yes.
Here we go.
Don't mess with us.
At least that thing was easy to kill. Thing's guts went flying feet in all directions. Oh, the humanity. Where am I? Well, we'll keep heading this way. Find the notes at the end here. Where was it? This way? Yeah. Little dead end passage. Okay. Gotta make sure that wasn't something that could just come out and attack us. Whoa! What the hell? Yikes! Hold up. Press the button. Whoa! Yeah, I'm hurt. I can't move. I can't. Yeah, I couldn't even shoot anymore. I think I couldn't. Was I out of ammo? When did I save last?
Okay.
Whoa!
Everyone all right?
Depends what you think of as all right. That didn't feel all right. Parasite egg pod. This vaguely gelatinous egg pod contains a parasite native to Eridanos still in its larval stage. The egg pod pulses at the touch. Oof. Well, didn't they say it wasn't native? Not overweight yet. Get me out of this thing. What the hell? Right. We're heading this way. Bad stuff happened. Switching weapons here. Wait, is this one? Yeah, it's not what I want. I'm messing around now. Ambush. Oh. Yeah, I am hurt. Yeah, I can't seem to survive this. And I'm stuck in place. I can't stop reloading. I can't move. I can't take cover. You need to move in order to take cover. That's the funny thing.
I can take a hint.
So I'm gonna run like hell. I'm just gonna shoot them and run like hell.
Here we go.
There's just too many, and then the thing runs in from over there. Hit and run tactics. Whoops. Maybe I'm stuck on this thing? That's why I can't move. Put your head up. Are these exploding things? Wow, it didn't even notice.
Here we go.
They really stopped chasing quickly. My legs. They're like, why do you keep running away, you coward?
We've got a fight on our hands. Fine hit, Captain. We are just that good.
Is it dead? Huh? That actually worked? What a thought. Here's the other one. Or two?